Namaste, everyone. Welcome back, and thanks again for joining me today, for listening to your body, for honoring your body. Today, I very much wanted to do a restorative practice for myself. I've had a busy week, and I just feel that I need to calm my body down. A lot of people ask what restorative yoga is, and it's just a very simple practice, a calm way of offering your body peace, a calm way to unite the body and the mind all through breath work, very much like an yin practice. It's a way to offer yourself respite, to disconnect from the fast, crazy way and pace of life that you may experience during the week. It's a way to almost offer your body a meditation, activating the parasympathetic nervous system through breath work. It's the opposite of a sympathetic nervous system, that fight and flight response. Instead, you're calming your body. You're inviting peace through your body, through poses that offer not only a restorative type of work for your body, for your muscles, for your mind, but help you relax in a spacious area, an area that you're controlling through your props, through your bolsters, your blankets. It's all about being cozy and offering your body comfort. And eventually, as you practice, you learn how to have that universal connection to the universe. It's a collective consciousness. It's something that's learned through experience. But once you reach that place of offering your body peace and calmness and kindness, all through grace and loving yourself, it's a beautiful experience. So we'll simply begin by finding a sukhasana, a comfortable, easy pose seat. We don't need much warm-up. We'll move into our restorative practice a little bit more quickly than a traditional yang practice. So just sit for a moment, rest your hands on your thighs. Keep your palms down to help ground you to the earth. If it's comfortable for you, just soften the gaze in your eyes a little bit. Just engage the belly, it's a nice way to begin. Reach your crown towards the sky and just notice, really notice the breath that moves through your body. Identify with your breath. Let it be your friend. Always let it be your teacher. Let it be your guide. Depending on how you feel today, how you need to move into each pose, what props do you have, do you need to help the pose feel a little bit more comfortable? But become aware of the breath, your life force moving through you now. A gentle inhale and an exhale. See if you could disconnect from all the activity of your mind. Let your mind quiet as your body softens and for a few moments finds a place of stillness, a place of peace. Let this be your special time. Let the place that you arrived at to use for your class, your room, your space, be your sacred place. Notice the breath, feel the breath. And feel your body slowly, mindfully, disconnecting from all activity, cultivating a place of peace, letting the mind focus, letting the nervous system be calm. And then if your eyes are closed, open your eyes slowly. Release your hands and just give yourself a big hug. Knowing that you're about to prepare to honor your body, to love your body, to be kind to yourself. Release your arms and let your left arm move overhead. Your right hand is on the mat. And then circle in front of you, releasing your left palm, your right hand lifts. Just gently follow and flow with the movement, focusing on the breath, warming the body, and releasing, and opening the side body. And one more time to the right, and one more time in the opposite direction. Come to a stillness. Make sure that for your restorative practice today, you have some props, whether it be bolsters or blankets, towel rolls, cushions. It doesn't have to be traditional yoga props. If you have them, that's great. Just see what you have around the house. Anything to tuck here and there, to offer comfort, to offer yourself. A modification is a great, great thing to have. So uncross your legs. And we'll prepare for our first restorative pose today. It's a restorative paschimottasana, a seated forward fold. If you have a bolster, you can find that now. If you only have blankets, you could just open your blankets, maybe fold them in half lengthwise, or you can even keep them in these little squares. You'll have to try it to see what's best for you. Extend your legs long on the mat. If you have your bolster, you can place it in front of you, on your lap, right up against your belly. If instead you're going to use your folded blankets, you can bunch them up, fold them up right across your torso, or even keep them lengthwise, and see which fold feels better for you. I'm going to time the poses for about 3 minutes. If you're doing your restorative practice at home, you can hold your poses anywhere from 3 minutes to 20 minutes, just depending on the time that you have for your practice, what feels right for you today. So begin by placing your bolster or your blanket along the length of your legs, right up against your belly, and simply fold forward. Allow your torso to be received by the bolster. You can place your hands stacked fists and let your head be received, or you can just keep your arms alongside the bolster, whatever feels comfortable for you. You could take another fold blanket if you have it, let your head be received by the folded blanket, or even a block. The main thing is to find comfort. If there's any tension underneath your hamstrings, take another blanket. Place it there. Restorative yoga is all about feeling cozy and comfortable. And then simply let yourself rest. Feel the length in your back body, in your legs. Know that the blood is circulating through all your organs in this pose, nourishing your organs. With each breath, allow yourself to soften a little bit more. Allow the mind to just be quiet. Allow the breath to nourish you. Focus on the breath. Come back to the breath. If it's at all uncomfortable to keep your head straight, you can turn your cheek, lower your arms, and just let your cheek rest on the mat. Maybe turning it halfway through into the opposite direction. You're welcome to stay in this restorative paschimottasana for as long as you'd like. And when you're ready to release, just straighten the torso. Lift the body up slowly, mindfully, coordinating breath to movement. Just release your bolster, your blankets. Keep all your props nearby. You'll need them for pretty much every pose today. Place the soles of your feet on the mat, your palms on the mat as well, and just windshield wipe your knees from right to left, offering a little movement. And then come to stillness. And we'll prepare for our next restorative pose, Supta Baddha Konasana, a restorative version of it. So again, if you have a bolster, that's great. You need a little elevation to your bolster this time, so you can use either a cushion, a blanket, or a block just to elevate the top of your bolster. So place the top of your bolster on the pillow or on the block. Come around so that your lumbar area, the back of your spine, your buttock area is close to the bolster. Your legs can begin to form the shape of Baddha Konasana now. If you keep them straight, however feels comfortable for you to get down to the mat. Have your bolsters and have your blankets and your blocks available. And then begin to come down to the mat. Maybe hold on to the bolster to help release your back body securely. Now, I prefer to take a folded blanket, maybe roll it a little bit, and place it underneath the backs of my knees. It offers a little support for the backs of my knees. Helps me feel comfortable, helps me feel cozy. You can take blocks and place them underneath your knees for support, maybe with the blanket or without it. Another nice touch that I like, if you have an extra blanket, I enjoy placing it underneath the soles of my feet and then wrapping my feet so that they're comfortable and secure and cozy. Laying myself down, having more blankets if I need, and you may choose to do the same for your arms on each side, or you can take your blocks and place them on each side. These are all modifications, all options that you can use. Oh, one other thing that I like to do for this pose is take a smaller folded blanket or a towel roll and place it under the crevice of my neck. Ah, it feels wonderful. And then again, I'm going to time the pose for about 3 minutes. Once you're in the pose, once you're in a class, your teacher, your instructor will come around and she'll offer you props, help with the tucking, so you don't have to do all the work yourself. But the whole idea of a restorative practice, just to let yourself feel cozy in a way that offers comfort. An instructor will always be watching you, see where you need an extra blanket. Everybody's body, everybody's position or shape of the pose is different. What works for one student may not work for the other. But when you find what feels comfortable for you, just settle in. Quiet the mind, focus on the breath. Know that there's a gentle stretch and opening in the groin. The pose should feel comfortable, it should feel safe. If at any time during the practice you do feel uncomfortable, maybe a little bit too exposed, like you do in Shavasana, you can take a blanket and place it over you, helping you to feel a little bit more safe, a little bit more less vulnerable. settling in, feeling safe, feeling at peace. Creating a space around you that feels right for the body. Knowing that within that safe space that you're creating, you're relaxing the body, you're calming the mind. Finding peace and stillness as you release, restore, renew the body, the mind. And again, rest in this restorative Supta Baddha Konasana for as long as you'd like. And when you are ready to release, let your arms move away from the props if you've used them. Uncover yourself and gather the knees together. Very slowly roll to a fetal position. Letting yourself release from the bolster and come down to the earth. Cradle your arm. Just rest in the fetal for a moment. Acknowledging the present moment. Acknowledging the kindness that you offer your body. Reconnecting with the breath. And then slowly beginning to push the earth away, keeping your head dangling, coming up last. Slowly, mindfully. Just sitting in the moment for a second or so. And then getting ready for your next pose, a restorative balasana, a wide leg child's pose. Now again, as in most restorative poses, you'll need your props, your blankets. So you can keep the bolster elevated either with your pillow, or if you only have a block, you can keep it elevated with the block. We'll try a block this time. Sit on your knees. It's a nice idea to take one of your blankets and place it at the bottom of your mat so that your knees have an extra layer of padding or cushion. Widen your knees, your big toes touch. Make sure your knees are on that extra folded blanket. Move your torso up towards the bolster or slide your bolster down. It's all about setup for restorative yoga. And then slowly lower the front body, the torso, right onto the bolster. You can hug the bolster. Cuddle yourself into the bolster and turn one cheek in one direction. About halfway through the pose, I'll remind you to turn your cheek in the opposite direction. Again, you're working the groin area. You're letting the bolster receive your front body. Releasing, snuggling into the bolster. Feeling relaxed. Letting the body just release to the earth. Feeling a groundedness. Feeling complete. Feeling at peace. letting the mind settle, the body settle. And when you're ready, you can just lift your chin slowly and turn your cheek in the opposite direction. Soften. Release. Feeling your buttocks move towards the soles of your feet, still connecting to the breath, expanding the side body, the ribs, and releasing and lowering towards the soles of your feet. A kind way to invite peace to the body. Again, restoring, renewing, releasing and letting go. Letting yourself feel all the emotions that move through your body. Letting yourself come in touch with your feelings. Acknowledging how you feel. And inviting the breath to move through you calmly, serenely. And as you're ready to release, turn the cheek towards the center, unsnuggle from the mat of the bolster, and slowly let yourself come up. Finding the breath, moving the bolster away, and letting the knees come together, just sitting in a hero's pose for a moment, grounding yourself, palms on your thighs. Realigning the breath, keeping it seamless, keeping it even. Never losing sight of the breath, your life force that moves through your body. And then opening your eyes and preparing for your next restorative pose. This pose is called a restorative bridge pose. So move your props away, and if you have a block or a stack of books, or even if you need to rest your back body on a bolster, that's fine. Come to sit on the bolster and let yourself come down on your back body. The soles of your feet are on the mat. Take your block, and you can keep it on the medium side, the low side, or the high side. But since this is a restorative class, it's nice to just keep it on the low side. Lift your hips a little bit and slide the block right underneath your sacrum. I'm going to come off of it for a minute because I want to make sure I have all my props available. So I'm lifting my hips. I'm reinserting the block underneath my sacrum. I'm going to walk my feet back a little bit. The soles of my feet are on the mat. I have a towel roll if I need to place underneath the back of my neck. Sometimes that feels just right. If I'm feeling exposed or vulnerable, again, you can take your blanket and just place it across your body. Sometimes the weight of a blanket on your thighs, on your abdomen, helps calm you. Arms are alongside the body. Again, you can rest your arms on a blanket if there's any discomfort, or if you want to treat yourself and offer yourself even more coziness, more comfort. Again, your yoga instructor will come around and help you with any of these modifications. If you're at home, you kind of have to do the work yourself. See how you feel. rest and release. And again, I'm timing each pose for about 3 minutes, maybe a little bit longer. Let the breath soften. The soles of your feet help keep you grounded. Your shoulders are doing much of the work. The block is supporting you. There's a gentle arch in your back. And your heart is open and exposed. Let yourself receive all the goodness of the universe in this pose. Let each breath, inhale and exhale, help you settle a little bit more. Let the mind chatter cease as you find clarity. Offer your body peace, respite, repose. A few more rounds of breath. And again, I invite you to stay in this restorative pose for as long as you'd like. And when you're ready to release, if your eyes were closed, open your gaze. Remove any blankets that you may have used to cover yourself. Lift the hips slightly. Release the block. Let your buttocks return to the earth and just hug your knees in for a moment. Massage the lower back, right to left. Always being kind to the body. And then release the soles of your feet to the earth. Again, roll to the right side. Pause for a moment in fetal. And slowly come up. Head comes up last. Let it dangle. Let it release. And then prepare for your next pose. This is a supported half frog pose. So we'll do our setup first. We'll make it easy. We're just going to flip our body around and do the opposite side. So take one blanket and fold it in half and just place it at the top of your mat. And then do the same with the second blanket. If you have a third blanket, just keep it nearby. You may need it. And slowly come down in a prone position on your mat. So that means your belly is on the mat. have that third blanket nearby. And very slowly let your right leg bend and come up onto that blanket. Now that's your layer of support there. Your right arm and your left arm can move into a simple goalpost. The right arm is being received by the other blanket that you folded. Now let your head come down and turn your cheek in the same direction as the knee that's lifted. And this is your half frog pose, restorative version. You can use the opposite the other blanket to receive your opposite arm. Or you, if it feels uncomfortable to keep your arms in stacked in goddess pose, just stack your fists and still let the blanket support you. See what feels right, and then settle into the pose. Halfway, well, we'll stay in this pose for about 3 minutes, and then we'll move to the opposite side. So let yourself settle, see what feels right for you. The left leg is long, the top of the foot is flat, and the right foot is bent. The foot on the right leg is just easy, relaxed. If there's any discomfort at all, you may need to rest your head on the blanket. Sometimes that feels good. Until you try different modifications, you really don't know what feels right. Just rest, release. It's a gentle release of the groin area, a mindful, restorative way. Stretch the body, letting the front body sink into the earth, ground into the earth. As you're ready to release your supported half frog, let your head come back to the center of the mat. Your right knee releases. And very slowly, just push the earth away, tuck your toes, and come into a table position for a moment. Wrists under shoulders. Keep the tops of your feet flat and just release into a cat dog. Tucking the chin, lifting the tailbone. And then reversing, just finding some movement with the spine. Come to a neutral spine, sit back on your heels, and simply turn your body around, slowly, mindfully. You may need to readjust your blankets. You're at the top of your mat now. The only blanket that you have to move is that third blanket that you had for your arm when you were in your goddess position. So, again, come down to your mat in your prone position. And this time, your left leg bends, finds that bottom blanket for support. come down and move your arms into Goddess. Both blankets receive your arms. And again, turn your cheek in the same direction as your bent knee. Now, you may need to readjust your blankets for comfort, but be mindful that your right leg is long and straight, your foot is easy, the knee is comfortable, supported on your left leg, and the left foot is just easy and resting and supported. Any difficulties in your neck, just tuck the blanket under a little bit. Let your body release, let your body soften. Close your eyes if that's part of your practice. Reconnect with the breath. Focus on keeping your body calm. Feel the peaceful movement of this posture move from your body. Releasing, letting go. Quieting your thoughts. Letting the mind chatter cease. Letting yourself arrive in this present moment. And as you're ready to release from this pose, head comes back to the center, left leg releases. Move the blankets away just a little bit so you can press into the earth. Lift yourself up, and again return to the table position. Come back on your knees. Hands rest on your thighs and just revel in the moment. Notice how the body feels, how the mind feels. And then prepare for a supported legs up the wall pose. And you need a wall or a closet for this pose, obviously. Take one of your blankets and place it on your mat for an extra layer of padding. If you have a sandbag, you can have your sandbag nearby. You may want to place that on the soles of your feet and that small towel roll or blanket for the crevice of your neck. So the best way to get into this pose is to scoot up against your wall or your closet and then let yourself come down on your hands all mindfully, all carefully and slowly. Your legs are going to come up right against the wall of the closet. If you have that towel roll and you need it under the back of your neck, you can place it there now. If you have a sandbag, you can bend your knees and place your sandbag on the tops of your feet. That'll give you some weight, some support. If you're feeling chilly or exposed or vulnerable, take a blanket and just place it over your torso, your body. You can use blocks or extra blankets to receive your arms if there's any discomfort by them being on the mat. Sometimes even that blanket that you used underneath your buttocks is enough. Just begin to settle into this pose. It takes a few minutes to find what feels right for your back body, your arms, your neck. When you do, again, allow the mind to soften, the breath to become a little bit more quiet, but notice the breath. Feel all the lymph drain through your body, nourishing the cells, nourishing the joints and the ligaments. This restorative pose is a really nice posture to do before you go to bed at night. Settle you, calm you. Inviting yourself to turn inward. Reminding yourself that your restorative practice is a way to help calm the mind, to take you away from all the craziness of your day, to help you relax, release. And integrate the calmness of the universe into the calmness of your body. Again, when you're in this restorative pose, you can stay here for as long as you'd like. And when you're ready to release, if you have a sandbag and there's no one around to help you release it, bend your knees and just find the strap of the sandbag so it doesn't fall on your body or your face. Move it over to the side. Let your legs slide down. Release to the side and push the earth away. And have all your favorite props around you as you prepare for your final restorative pose, the way we end all our yoga practices, a yin, a yang, or restorative class, or shavasana. So come down on your back body. You can either use a bolster onto the backs of your legs, or you can, again, roll up one of your blankets, place it under your back of your knees. Let everything be soft. You can use a blanket under your back body as an extra layer of padding. That's sometimes nice in shavasana, a restorative shavasana. And have your towel roll handy for the back of your neck. And let your body come down onto the mat. Place the towel roll under your neck. Readjust your blanket for the backs of your knees. Let your feet splay apart comfortably, and your arms as well. And invite yourself to just settle in. Let your body feel all the subtle energy that you created in your restorative practice. See if you feel peaceful. See if you feel a little bit calmer. And let yourself release mindfully in the present moment, breath by breath, into a subtle stillness. Giving yourself thanks, honoring your body. I invite you to stay in your shavasana for as long as you need. And when you decide you're ready to release, find a gentle movement of your fingers, of your toes. Let the soles of your feet return to the mat. Stretch overhead. If you need to realign your body, or if that feels right for your neck and your back, roll to your right side, heart closest to the earth, knees tucked, head cradled. And just rest and think about what kindness you just offered your body in your restorative practice. You listened to your body, you honored your body. Maybe you even tried new things. It's all wonderful. Press into the earth, letting the head dangle and come up last. And find a comfortable pose for yourself, the Sukhasana. Let your hands move in front of your heart center and bow your head in gratitude and in thanks. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. May there be peace, 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 as you walk this earth all the days of your life. Namaste. Thank you for joining me today and for honoring and listening to your